Hello and welcome to the Drama Club Cooking Show. My name is Jamison, and today we'll be making picadillo. So first things first, we're gonna start off with one green bell pepper. And how we're gonna cut this is we're just gonna cut around the edge of the top just to make sure that we can pull out the seeds in one motion. So once you have the top off, you should just be able to pull out the entire thing. And I like to have a bowl on the side to keep all of my vegetable waste so that I can compost it later. So next, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna cut it on the bottom side. You'll see that there are bumps, and you're just gonna cut it right down the middle of those. And then when you have it like this, you're just gonna cut out the white portion of it. And when you're cutting a pepper, you wanna make sure you're always cutting from the inside, because the flesh on the outside, so the skin, is typically very hard to cut through. So once we get that into about 5 equally sliced sized pieces, we're just gonna go through and chop those up. Again, you're gonna wanna make sure they're about the same size all the way through. Once we have those cut up, we're just gonna put them into a bowl and continue topping the rest. So now I have one whole green bell pepper chopped up. I'm just gonna place that off to the side, and now we're gonna move on to our red bell pepper. You're gonna do the exact same thing, cut it from the top to get the seeds out into finely sliced pieces to where they're about equal to the width and the size of your green bell pepper. And once you start getting that chopped up, you can just add them right into your bowl with your green pepper. Now we have the rest of our red pepper chopped up. We're again just gonna place it off to the side, and then we're gonna grab our large sweet onion. So first things first is you're gonna wanna cut the bottom off so that you have a nice flat surface. And then once you're done with that, you're just gonna peel the sides off. What I like to do is I like to score the first layer, and then it just starts to peel off from there. Now we have a nice clean onion. We're just gonna cut it right down the middle. And you wanna make it a point that this top piece is intact, because that's what's gonna keep all the layers together. So the first step that we're gonna do is we are gonna cut it from the bottom. We're just gonna make slits going along all the way to the top. You're gonna get about 5 slits, which will be just the right amount. We wanna try and make sure that they're equally spaced out so that we can all have the same size onions. Next thing we're gonna do is you're just gonna start slicing down. And you're gonna try to make those equally spaced out along the onion. And then all you're gonna do is just dice it from the top. Now, as you can see, the onion is just doing the work itself. So we're gonna take a separate bowl and we're gonna place them into a separate bowl. We're just gonna do the exact same thing to the other side with the onion. And just set that off to the side. The next thing we're gonna be working on is our poblano pepper. So what you're we're just gonna cut it right down the middle on both sides. And then usually you can just spread it open. And then once you get to the top, just cut out the seeds. And we're gonna cut the poblano pepper in half on both sides. And just like our other peppers, you're gonna wanna cut from the flesh, not the skin on the outside, because it is, again, much harder to cut through. We can just add that into our bowl with our red and green peppers. Now that we've chopped up our poblano pepper, And we're just gonna set that bowl off to the side and start working on our pan. So first things first, we're gonna wanna make sure you have a neutral oil in the pan. So you just wanna apply about 2 tablespoons and turn your pan onto medium. So you're gonna notice that your pan is hot enough to cook with when your oil is liquidy and coats the pan. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna add in our onions. Just gonna stir those around and get them coated in oil. And we're gonna let that cook for about 2 minutes. So next thing we're gonna start doing is we're gonna take our 1/2 cup of olives and just cut them in half. Gonna place those back in the bowl so that they're ready for later. Next thing we're also gonna do is we're gonna take our cilantro and our Italian parsley and just give it a nice rough chop. And do the exact same thing with our cilantro. And just set that off to the side as we'll use it later. Now that our onions have been cooking for about 2 minutes, we're gonna add in all of our peppers. We're just gonna stir that in and make sure everything is incorporated. Just gonna let that cook, giving it the occasional stir until the onions are translucent. And while we're waiting for that to heat up, what we're gonna do is we're gonna dice our plantain. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna squirt it down the middle. And then again down the back. And if your plantain isn't as bright as mine, a little hack and a little trick is to actually squirt just like I did and run it under the faucet for cold water for about 30 seconds and the skin should just peel right off. So we're gonna peel our plantain. Just gonna cut it right down the middle. And then we're just gonna chop it. And you set it off to the side. So now that our peppers and our onions have been cooking for a few minutes, what we're going to do is we're going to add 1 whole clove of minced garlic. So now that our onions and our peppers have been cooking for a few minutes, I have 1 whole bunch of garlic and I threw it in there, and now I'm just going to let that simmer for a few minutes. And keep an eye on those onions, because once they turn translucent, that's your indicator to add meat. So now that most of our onions are translucent, we're gonna go over and we're gonna get our 2 pounds of, here we have ground beef, but you can use any ground substitute that you choose to make. We're just gonna add that in. You're just gonna wanna break that. Some of your onions and peppers spill over. I do it all the time. But you're slowly just gonna want to start rounding it up. And as you're incorporating your peppers and your onions into the meat, you're gonna notice that your meat has started to brown. And once your meat is mostly brown, that's when you're gonna want to add in a can of crushed tomatoes. So we're just gonna leave this for a few minutes to brown up. And then once most of it is brown, we're gonna add in our 28-ounce can of crushed tomatoes. And as you can see, our meat is a nice light brown color, which is the indication that we need to add our crushed tomatoes. So now that we've added our 28-ounce can of crushed tomatoes, we're just gonna mix that around, make sure everything is nice and incorporated. And we're just gonna let that simmer for a few minutes. So now that our meat looks almost fully cooked, we're gonna add in our plantains, along with 2 tablespoons of tomato juice. and we're just gonna mix it all together. So next thing we're gonna do is we're just gonna add in our half cup of halved olives, our 2 tablespoons of capers. We're gonna add in our already chopped Italian parsley and cilantro. And then you're gonna salt and pepper it to taste. And just mix that all in. And once we have all our ingredients incorporated, we're just gonna let this simmer for about 15 more minutes and then it'll be ready to serve. Now that we've let our picadillo sit for about 15 minutes, it looks great. All of the water has cooked off. So just give it one last good stir. Take it off the heat and let it sit for about 5 more minutes just to cool up, and then you're ready to serve it. So here I have about a cup of rice. I pre-made this while my picadillo was cooking, and I'm just gonna place the picadillo over it. However, you can serve it with Cuban bread. You can put the picadillo in empanadas. Picadillo is so versatile and so delicious, and you can eat it in so many different ways. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take my picadillo that's been resting and cooling off for about 5 to 10 minutes, and I'm just gonna serve it over the butter rice. And once I have my picadillo served, if I have any leftover parsley or cilantro, I like to chop it up and just add a nice little garnish on top. So now I'm just gonna take this cilantro and parsley that I chopped up and just add a little bit on top. It adds some nice, beautiful green color. So now we have here our beef picadillo on a bed of rice. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed the recipe. The Drama Club Cooking Show is sponsored by the Florida Keys Council of the Arts and Williams Hall.